Hey everyone, I want to start by saying something that I don't think I've ever said before, and you'll probably never hear me say again, and that's this. I have some very unexciting news to share with you. Yep, you heard that right. I have some unexciting news to share, but then after that, I have some exciting reasons why the unexciting news is important, even though it's not all that exciting. Do you get that? Well, let's start with the unexciting news. Here goes. We're changing to a new online giving platform, and we need just 2 minutes of your time to move your donation from the old platform to the new one. The new platform is called PushPay, and it offers lots of advantages, both to the church on the back end and also to the users on the front end. It makes things a lot simpler, especially if you're using your phone or your tablet. And who doesn't want things to be simpler, especially these days? With just a couple of clicks, you'll be able to make a one-time donation or set up a recurring one and then modify it anytime you like. You'll also be able to see your yearly donation summary at any time as well. Now, what we need from you is to move your recurring donation from the old platform to the new one, a process that will literally take less than 2 minutes of your time. In this email, you'll find step-by-step instructions on how to do everything you need, whether it's setting up a new donation or moving an existing one to the new platform. It's so simple that I just moved my own donation and the entire process took me less than 60 seconds to accomplish. So there, now all you competitive people have something to aim for. Good luck beating that. So that's it. That's the news. Was I right about the unexciting part? At least you can't say I didn't warn you or that I gave you false hope. But while I got your attention, let me share some exciting reasons why this news is important. We all know that the last 8 months have been unprecedented in so many ways. You certainly don't need me to tell you about that. But in the midst of so much uncertainty and instability, there's one thing that hasn't changed at all, and that's you and your generosity. In a year which saw a lot of people suffer serious financial hardships, and a lot of churches as well, your generosity has allowed STSA to not only survive this challenging time, but actually to thrive and in many ways to grow during this year. And for that, I want to say thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you not just for the gift that you've given, but thank you for the example that you've set. It speaks volumes as to your love for God and your trust in His promise. It also speaks to my sincere belief that God has a very special mission for this church and that He who began a good work here has a lot more that He wants to do both in us and through us in the future. And in case you're wondering what I'm talking about, let me share just a few highlights of what your generosity has allowed us to do in just the past 6 months alone. Thanks to your generosity, we've been able to serve over 21,000 meals in just the past 6 months to children and families living in food insecure situations in the DC area. We've done that through Hope Multiplied, our community impact organization that works to meet needs in the local community. Through Hope, we've also provided over $10,000 of support to struggling small businesses, all family-owned and locally operated. In addition, programs like our mentoring program, which provides support to at-risk children and teens, programs like this didn't stop. We had plenty of reasons to put them on the shelf for now, but we felt like these programs were needed now more than ever. So we found a way to adapt them so that we can continue to provide these kids with the positive role models they so desperately need. And that's all thanks to your generosity. How about within our own church community? Thanks to your generosity, we've been able to meet the needs of our own church members who've experienced significant hardship as well, whether financial or non-financial. Like the single mother of 3 kids who came here seeking asylum and needed a place to stay. Eventually, she needed help moving to another state where the cost of living was considerably less and jobs were a lot easier to find. It took just one email that I sent to about 7 or 8 families, and within hours, we collected everything we needed to meet this family's need and set them up for success in their new home. And to be honest, that's just one example, but I could tell you 3 or 4 more just like it, and they all go something like this. A family in dire straits, oftentimes a single mom with kids, who needs help. I send an email to people who have told me in the past, we want to help, and I offer them a chance to donate towards this cause. And within hours, the need is met every single time. The family's taken care of, and the name of the Lord is magnified. And the best part is that it's the church, the body of Christ, that gets all the credit. More often than not, these same people who received the help come back to the church later on and insist on paying the money back after they've been able to stand on their own 2 feet, and that's all thanks to your generosity. Now forget about financial, let's talk ministry. At a time when many churches are scaling back and struggling to keep people engaged, thanks to your generosity, the opposite has happened at STSA. We've actually grown the church during this time. We've added several new members, many of whom entered the church through baptism. In fact, we've actually baptized 7 adults over the past 6 months alone, each of whom has a great story to share about how God brought them here. The ministry also grew by adding a second location in Leesburg, a location that, by the way, is now filling up at almost the same rate as our first location in Arlington. So again, at a time when many churches were cutting back and trying to figure out how to survive, thanks to your generosity, we were able to expand and start service in a new city. And of course, that's not even to mention the most visible sign of our church's growth, which is that we added a third priest in Father Abraham. This is something that we absolutely could not have done and would not have done without your generosity. So again, thank you. One last thing. All these things that are happening are not just at a time of instability and uncertainty all around us, but also in the midst of a major church building project that's set to break ground in early 2021. COVID not only didn't slow us down, in fact, it created an environment that stands to benefit the church tremendously economically. And for that, we thank God. But did you know that this multi-million-dollar project, which is completely outside of our regular operating expenses and budget, has gotten this far and we have yet to take out a single penny from a bank as a loan? That's unheard of. We're more than $500,000 into the project, and thanks to your generosity, we've been able to make all of our payments without going to the bank once and without ever having to stand in front of the congregation asking for money. That's truly unheard of. And speaking of unheard of, let me tell you what else the church has been able to do thanks to your generosity. In just a few months, we'll be able to complete our 9th year of operations at STSA. And did you know that in those 9 years, we have accumulated exactly $0 of debt? Think about that for a second. 9 years of operations, 3 priests, 2 locations, 1 piece of land worth more than $2 million that we own free and clear, and $0 of debt. How can that be? Simple. It's thanks to your generosity. So again, I want to say thank you. Thank you for giving so generously, not just of your money, but of your time and your prayers and your love. You're the reason that God has used STSA to do so much in just 9 years. You're also the reason that I know He's got much more planned for years to come. And in case you've forgotten about it by now, please take a look at the links in this email to get your donation either set up or moved over to our new giving platform. God has great plans to use STSA, and I want to be sure that you don't miss out on being part of it. Finally, I'll leave you with a verse. It's the verse that I have hanging on my wall and the one that I read every morning when I stand up to pray. It's 1 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 10, and it says this: "Consider now, for the Lord has chosen you to build a house for the sanctuary. Be strong and do it." Thank you for answering His call to build His house and to do something great for His name. I pray that God's blessing in your life would be just as great as your generosity has been for His church. God bless you all.